So, you have finally found me. It seems not even the dead can escape you. You have came here for a story, haven't you? It is that time of the year, is it not? A story that will entice your heart and petrify your soul. Well, you have come to the right place then. I have just the thing for you. This one is one of my personal favorites. It tells the tale of a man who sought out all the hidden treasures of this world. A man who knew nothing more but isolation and loneliness. A journey so long and full of mysteries beyond your understanding. I have kept this one in a very good shape, just for you. Welcome to Sanctum's Story Island. It all started many years ago, when this land was full of life and adventure, when the grass was singing and the trees were dancing, when mankind sought ascendance, not demise, at the very edge of the island, where things started to take a turn for the worse. The Fang of Cavalot. It was near midnight. The streets of Cavalot were empty and quiet. The air was cold and unwelcoming. But in the homes of the villagers, everything felt right. A single guard patrolling the streets all by himself. A single man that barely kept awake under the chilling fog that was covering Cavalot. As the night grew darker and deeper, every single soul laid to rest in their cozy, warm homes. No footsteps could be heard from the villagers of this small forgotten place. Suddenly, gentle squeaks and cracking moved in the silent night. Footsteps that can barely be heard whispered in the dark. A single man that did not sleep has come to visit Cavalot. Tall, rugged, and covered in black leather. A long dark hood to protect him from the cold, and a mask that could not cover his identity. Gracefully, he started to make his way through the village. He did not live here. He did not belong. Yet every move he made had a purpose, had a reason. He knew how to stay undetected, and he knew exactly what to do. Cavalot was not just a mere village of peasants and simple-minded men. Cavalot had something much more than that. In this part of the world, there used to be an explorer that lived here. One that had searched many lands, many lairs. After a long, long search, the explorer finally discovered it. It was an artifact like no other. A gemstone that can give power, energy, even life to every single thing you, the holder, could desire. But he knew better. if he was to return to Cavalot with this gemstone, he would bring his own demise. So he hid it, so deep and so far, that even he had troubles finding it. Then, a few weeks later, he was found dead along the roads of a nearby village. The only thing he left behind was a clue that only few can decipher. The thief was one of the very few. He was already on the trail of this treasure, but the night was concealing others that were after him. The thief looked around, and he saw a dusty book. But this type of book did not belong among all of these clues and riddles. This was a book that can only be found in a place of value and culture, a place of science and curiosity. He turned around as he kept reading small parts of the book and walked over to a final piece of the puzzle that was dangling from the wall. He put down the book and saw workings and scratches. Someone had copied the clue. As he was staring at the wall and the puzzle, a horrifying howl shook him up. This night was far from over. As he set foot outside, he made his way on the rooftop, his eyes looking up, frozen over the image of the place he knew the gem was. Castle Frankenstein, his next destination. He looked down onto the patrolling guard, and he knew going back through the same path would only take longer. He turned around, facing the ruins of the old bell tower. That would be the much easier way out. With a swift leap off the edge, he quickly fell onto the ground and ran towards it. It was time to visit the castle and find his treasure. Deep from the forest, heavy steps were rushing in. Heavy breathing and growling was breaking the silence in the forest. Red eyes, long dark claws, and fangs that can't penetrate even the strongest armor were flying through the dark forest. The thief was nearly out. All he had to do was reach the top of the ledge and escape the dark forest. Other stories, other journeys. And the thing is, everything here is connected. For now we place down this book and we reflect from above. And you, I will see you with the next story.